500 for 10 sets of 5. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Road to 800. Don't forget to like this channel, share this channel, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed. 500 pounds for 10 sets, 5 reps. Total poundage moved was 25,000 for the bench press. Altogether, 46,000 for overall, including the winning warm-ups. But the winning warm-ups really worked. I'm saying as far as like my joints, tendons, muscles, everything was warmed up before I hit the bench press today. So things moved a lot faster, a lot smoother. And I'm pretty sure we did all this in maybe an hour, 20, hour, 30 minutes. Today, coming into this workout, I've been having some inflammation on the elbow, on both my elbows, and that's very rare for me. I think it's because of the increase in volume. So what we did was we hit multiple different angles, covering all points of joint pressure. So whenever I'm going into bench press today, I feel like I'm already warmed up and I don't have to increase my volume as far as warm-ups on the flat bench. So what we did, we just used that for accessories. So that kind of really hit every point that I needed it to hit. It actually stretched, like elongated those tendons in there. When I did the reverse grip lat pull down, it just feel like it. So I'm always like this.
Turn like this, loosen it up.
Yeah.
So when you start having all these little tiny issues, it might be you're overusing the exact same angle too often, which is very easy for bench-only guys or even traditional powerlifters, right? We don't ever want to get put in those positions we're not strong. Well, if you're using it as a light warm-up where the ego is not attached, you're actually creating some benefit, you're creating some rehabilitation in your training, and you're doing 300 reps in 12 minutes. So in 12 minutes, we just did 300 reps of exercises to build more muscle mass, more ligament and tendon density, and now he's fresher and ready to go. Think about like taking sand in a tunnel and shaking it. Your nervous system comes down into that fine point, and now he's ready to bench press.
Usually whenever I'm warming up, I might do tricep extensions, but the weight is a little heavier, so it kind of irritates the joints even more. And by the time I'm warming up on bench, I want to make sure that I'm properly warmed up. A lot of times, whenever I reach my top set, I'm already fatigued because I warmed up on the bench instead of like we did today when you warm up. So yeah, they feel great. Everything feels warmed up.
So now we're ready to actually bench press. The key is to warm up, not destroy. You want to stimulate and not annihilate, because he's got to do 10 sets of 5 today with 500 pounds on the bench press. So anything we do to aggravate that before that happens is going to decrease the load and the way that's supposed to feel, making him struggle with that weight even more so because of the volume side, because he's got all these little bumps and bruises from doing the warm-up too heavy. He's an 800-pound bencher, and we just use 35-pound dumbbells for a warm-up. But why? Because it's a warm-up.
He benching 600 flip-flops. He's doing 800 in Air Maxes.
Yeah. We're about to get started, guys. So check this out. Today we have 10 sets of 500 pounds for 5 reps. 50 reps of 500 pounds. So a little bit of clean down for you. Clean food for me. Clean food, though. We dialed everything down as far as intensity-wise, which is weight, just so we can rebuild. We're building a stronger foundation, starting from foot placement to hand placement, keeping my back tight, utilizing leg drive, the descend speed, where the bar is brought out to where I start the press. So it's the small things that matter whenever it comes to being an 800-pound bencher. And these are things that everybody can implement into their workout, not just because that I'm a 800-pound bencher. Like, for overall, just being able to stay away from injuries and things like that is trying to utilize proper form. Again, guys, I hope you enjoy the video. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's go.